Oh, hi. Before we start the tutorial, I have to say thank you for all of you. My subscribers has become over 1,000. Wow, yay. I really appreciate it. 감사합니다. Today, we're gonna learn instance geometry with mouse interactive. Let's make a box. Make it long. Using center to place it on 0 of y-axis. Make transform. And set uniform scale to 0.1. Make material. Make PBR and drag it to the material. Reduce metallic to smooth the surface. Make null. Make a geometry. Make render and set its resolution. Make a camera. Make a light. Make a null. And make an environmental light. I simply use noise at this time, but I recommend you to set another environment map. Go and check my video about PBR. Make an RGB key to fill background with black. If you modify camera, it'll look another place, so drag on her to make it keep looking at 000 position. Go to the view and set projection to orthographic. Basically, camera has been set to perspective, but if you set it to orthographic, there would be no perspective anymore, which makes it unique. Make a grid and set it to ZX plane. Make it big and make it have many points. Make a null. Make a top soap tool. Drag null to soap tool. It transforms soap's position X, Y, Z into top. It means that all of the points' positions on x, y, z axis become tx, ty, tz each. Make a null. I'll set its name to instancing. Select geometry and turn on instancing. Drag instancing null here. Type the tx, ty, tz to set translate x, y, z. Go to camera and turn on pre-X form. Let's type apps times and seconds to see what happens. Yes, it shapes like this. Select transform, which is located next to box to set uniform scale little bit smaller. As you can see, all of these are boxes. Here is grid. It has 900 points. By instancing, boxes are duplicated by the number of its points. So, if you change the grid's rows and columns, it means to change the number of points, therefore to change the number of boxes. If I make noise here, the shape of grid becomes like this. The transformed top decides the box's position, as well as grid. If we use sphere, it will follow the sphere's point's position too. Let's do it simpler. Make a constant. Let's make x, y, and size constant and set values like this. Beckoner, here is the little tip for chop referencing. Press A to activate and drag XY to create rows for chop referencing. I'll copy the expression and paste it to columns so that it can use the same values. Drag size here to chop reference both at once. Now, we can control grid's points count easily. And for its size too. Let's use math. Make a select. Copy and paste it. Press right side button and select XY and size each to separate themselves. Make a mesh. Connect both selects to the mesh. And set it to divide. But it's in the wrong order. Let's change the order by pressing this button. Press A to activate and drag it to transform's uniform scale. Now, if you change the size or point count, the gap of boxes will be constant. Make a noise. This is an example, so modify it however you want. Drag XY constant to noise resolution. Make a null. Make a chop top 2. Drag null to top 2. The images are converted into RGBA color values. But we using monochrome images, so delete them except for the red. So, is this image really transformed to chop perfectly? It's not. We have to set it to full image in crop. Now, we have lots of complicated channels. What are these? X resolution of this image is 30, and the X resolution becomes the channel's length. Its Y resolution is 30 as well. The Y resolution becomes the channel's count. Black is 0, so that the channel's start is 0. White is 1, so that the channel's end is 1. But don't get confused. The image's top and bottom will be reversed like this. So let's connect. No! There are too many channels. Make a shuffle. Set method to sequence channels by name. It combines multi channels into a single channel. If you make info and drag it, length is 900. It's the same with soft length too. Now, we can use this. Make rename. And type ty in 2. Now, there are two ty channels, so we need to insert a select here. Type tx and tz here to delete the original ty channel. Insert merge here. Drag the new TY to merge. Now, the noise's black and white values became box's Y positions. But we're not going to use this noise. Make a circle. Set its resolution a little bit smaller. And set circle's size small. Make a transform. Make a mouse into get our mouse position. Type left at left button to get mouse click response. And I'll modify the mouse Y position by normalized. Let's set TX and TY to transform's XY position. Now, a circle follow our mouse. Make a lever. Set left to the lever's opacity. Now, the circles only appear when we click a mouse button. Okay, let's try some feedback. Make a null. Make a composite here and set it to add. Make a feedback from null. Make a lever. Connect to comp and drag comp to feedback. Set lever's opacity to 0.35. Insert blur here and modify filter size. Insert edge next to it. Set its strength and turn on comp over input. If you want to understand more about feedback, please check my previous video about feedback. Make a null. Insert a lever and give it more contrast. Insert a threshold to make the image clean. Insert a blur to make the image soft. Delete the noise and blur. And it's not, because the image is so big. It will exceed the greatest points count. Make a fit and set its resolution using XY constant. I'll turn off interpolate. Now, if we drag it to top 2, it becomes like this. I think this movement is a bit too much, so let's make a mesh to make it move less. Now, let's stop the camera rotating. As top and down margins are not the same, let's change null's position to change camera's direction. Okay, make a grid for a background. Make it big. Make a material and drag the same PBR that used on a box. Make a geometry. Let's modify the light. setting light is very important. It can make the final result really good or bad by the way you set it. I'll make some shadow too. But there is a little problem. The mouse position looks different because of the camera angle. Let's add rotate constant. I'll set it to 45 degrees, as same as camera's rotation value. Set it to transform's rotate value, which is located next to circle. And change transform order. Now, it's identical with the camera angle. Let's set the camera's rotate to rotated with the same value. Now, it's synchronized perfectly. And it's done. Thank you for watching. If you do Patreon for me, you can download a project file. I'll come back with a better tutorial next time. Okay, bye.